Hi, my name's Isabel and I'm one half of Fat Life Drawing. Today I'm going to be hosting and modelling for a portrait session for the arts group Rural Arts based in Thirsk. So today we're going to be playing around with some lighting, different length poses and some props. What I'd recommend is you put on your favourite music. You can mute this because I'll make sure everything's subtitled so you can still read along and just take some time and relax, and I feel like life drawing should really be seen as a bit of a mindful session. Just take this as half an hour to yourself and just try not to stress too much about making everything perfect and just have fun. One of the most common problems people face when first starting life drawing is projecting what your own preconceptions of what a person should look like rather than what is in front of you. I know I'm a victim of this habit as well. So it's important to focus on things like foreshortening. Are you drawing the arms too long because that's how you expect them to look? Are you too afraid to make a face look squished because you're used to drawing people straight on? It is uncomfortable to take yourself out of these habits, and at first you may be unhappy with the outcome, but in the long run, this is a really simple and easy way for you to begin to develop your style and to come out of your comfort zone. So we're going to begin with a simple 2.5 minute pose, just looking straight on. It's best to divide the face into equal thirds to help with your proportion. Go from the hairline to the brow to the bottom of the nose, and the bottom of the nose to the chin. For the lower third, this could be split into two and give you an idea of where the bottom of the mouth is. So we've got another 2.5 minute pose. This one has a lot more going on, but don't let that put you off working from the time frame. Just get your vague shapes in first, a circle shape for the flowers, semicircle for the shoulders, oval for the head, etc. Then come back and rewatch this pose for another 2.5 minutes and begin to fill in these details. So this is our final 2.5 minute pose. For this one, maybe focus on proportion, see how the arms take up the entire canvas and test yourself by drawing hands. Alternatively, it's often said when drawing from life you should be looking at the model more than you are your paper, so if you're feeling brave, treat this as an extra warm-up exercise, draw from this pose without looking at your paper at all. So now we're moving on to 5 minute poses. For this one, I want you to focus on the light and shadow. See where your light is coming from, not only from the bottom left hand side, but the additional light from the candle. How does this affect the shape of the face, and what stands out in this pose? Thank you. Again, this 5-minute pose concentrates on light and shadow. If you can, play around with the colour for this one. Take note of how the angle of the face and the light coincide to create a much higher contrast, especially in the face where there is a much larger disparity between the highlights and shadows. With this pose, you can imagine a line running down the centre of the face. This far side of the face has harsh highlights, whilst the near side features are more mid and shadow tones, giving the face dimension. and we finish with the final 5 minute pose. See if you can play around with the fabric texture against the black background to challenge yourself. Poses with heads back can often mean the end result of the person's face looking quite squished. Using the shading here is a really useful way of enhancing a drawing like this to look more 3D. So earlier we talked about relative distance and splitting the face into thirds. For this one, the angle of my face is tilted backwards, so let's see how we can adapt to this. Start from the distance from the bottom of the chin to the bottom of the nose. How does this compare to the bottom of the nose to the eyebrows? And again, from the eyebrows to the hairline. The proportion has changed with the angle, so take some time to map this out before you begin with the heavier lines. So that's all for the life drawing session today. Short and sweet, but I will put down all the timings of each poses, so if you want to go back and rewatch and spend a bit longer, you can. And join me for another life drawing. We do Fat Life Drawing every week, so the next one will be on Sunday. All proceeds go to the Model's Choice of Charity. So far we've raised an incredible over £6,000. So yeah, donate £5 to that Model's Charity and you can join us on Sundays. Thank you.